Well, good morning. These are the announcements for July 19th, the seventh Sunday after Pentecost. These are announcements that we would have shared had we been allowed to gather together. Of course, the one that we should put right up top, the one that many of you are wondering about, is when will we be allowed to gather together? And as of today, and you understand that these are all tentative, right? That things can change, and they can change very rapidly. As of today, we are looking to begin with outdoor worship in mid-August. August 16th is our target date. We believe that by that time we will be able to gather outdoors safely without putting our most vulnerable members at risk. And so that is our target. And more information will be coming in subsequent weeks and days here. Just a word though, a reminder, we have absolutely no intention of any kind of stopping doing the online work that we're doing. In fact, we want to do it. We want to do more of it. We want to do it better because we understand that there are some people who will be loath to come into groups, even outdoors, for quite some time. And this is your church, and nothing is going to be taken away from you. We're talking about adding, not subtracting, and that is where we think the future is going. Now, in terms of our life together at this moment, let's focus on things that we know with rather more certainty. We know of no one in the hospital. We had a member who had some tests that all turned out very well indeed, and so we're grateful to God for that, and we continue to covenant with one another to pray for one another, and that prayer list is always available on the upper tab of our website, and I commend it to you. Remember, there is a Panda Express fundraiser that is next Friday the 24th. There is a link below where you can click, get a little form. You show that form when you go through the drive-through, and our youth group automatically gets 20% of whatever it is that you spend. So you're probably going to do dinner out, dinner in a drive-through sometime in the next 10 days. How about the 24th? How about using that and supporting our youth group at the same time? Again, we are collecting nature photos. If you have photos of sunsets or rocks or plants or flowers or trees, send them in. We are putting together a little multimedia thing and would be grateful for your contributions. As always, our most updated information available to us about all things pandemic is available on our website. Links also to the Synod's website where you can read and learn all of the things that are going on and all of the things that need to be addressed for our life together. There is a golf outing coming up. It's coming up on August 11th, but if you're going to be part of it, you need to register by July 20th, which is coming screaming up, right? So if you've always wanted to beat a Lutheran bishop at golf, this is your big shot. You do need to sign up, and you do need to figure out all of the things that you need to do in advance of that. So I commend that to you. Any of you peace members, especially, who have an hour or two to help and are not afraid of heights, we need some gutters cleaned here at Peace, and just call the church office. Let me know if you are willing to do that. We are having water overtopping gutters again, and that leads to a whole cascade of problems of which you are most familiar. So let us know if you can help us with some gutter cleaning. Any of you who would like to be more connected to the church, be sure to follow us on Facebook. It's the Tomorrow River Lutheran Parish is what you would look up for Facebook. And you can get the daily prayers that we're doing, the ongoing submissions from the ELCA. It's not really a submission when somebody higher gives it to you, is it? But the ELCA sends announcements and prompts, and you'll get all of that and anything else that we put up if you sign up for Facebook, follow us on Facebook. Confirmation students, again, we're into the middle of July. If your parents decide to wrap it up for you for the year, that's fine with me. Let us know where you are, what you accomplished in terms of worship attendance and church hours and service hours and all of those things. We are in the process of setting the table again for next year, and we are hoping that we can do in person, but we are also preparing against the possibility that we're going to be doing online Google Classroom sorts of gatherings. So we'll continue to use video format, but we will also do meetings on Wednesday night. Who knows how long this goes? And so we're going to, at worst, we'll have an adaptive program where Wednesday night is still confirmation night. Just a reminder that all of you are invited to continue to go through Luther's Small Catechism. We are doing weekly lessons, and then after the lesson, people send in questions and we do a weekly response. So there are two videos every week on some part of Luther's Small Catechism, and we are making good progress through. If you want to start now, you can. You're 26 videos behind. But the videos are going to be there. You could do one or two a day and you'd be caught up in no time at all. So they're on the website. Look under Catechism Class and you will find links to all that we have done on Luther's Small Catechism. A final reminder that we continue to be willing to distribute everything that we're doing online on DVDs for people who need them. If you can think of someone who might benefit from a DVD, let us know and we'll make contact with them and see if they want to be included to that mailing list. By the same token, you are welcome to forward any of our videos to anyone you choose. There's no holding close with this. We're casting our bread upon the waves. And if you think that someone somewhere else might benefit from something that I or Pastor Gretchen says, we are humbled by your confidence and grateful that you would pass things out. Those are the announcements. I am so grateful that we are church together. I am so grateful to let you know and to remind you that the church has never closed. Not once, not ever, not since Jesus rose. The church has never closed. We continue to do our work. We continue to care for those in our midst who have need as we become aware of it. You continue to be God's church deployed in the world, God's ambassadors in the world. And you have continued to pray for us, to support us financially, to bless and protect this community by your attention to being the church of God in this place. And so may God bless you. May God protect this church, and may God fill us all with light. In Jesus' name, amen.